Cake. 1920, Joe Stecker beat Earl Craddock. 1940, Ray Steele beat Bronco Nagurski. In 1980, Tommy Rich beat Harley Race. There's only been three title changes to start a decade. Will this be number four?
This could be the fourth one, Jim. 1990, the start of the new decade.
Baltimore, the site of the last three bashes, but never the site of a world title change. Will this be the night?
Of this World Heavyweight Championship match, the stipulations presented and demanded by Executive Vice President of World Championship Wrestling, Jim Herd. This match must be won by pinfall or submission. The Steiner Brothers, the Junkyard Dog, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, the dudes with attitudes surrounding the ring, and also Ole Anderson to be handcuffed to 7 foot.
Ole Anderson, very irate, but he's not going to be nearly as irate now as he is about right now.
What's this?
El Gigante says, you're going back here. Anderson will not be at ringside. Apparently, Ole Anderson will be well up the ramp. Jim Herd, Executive Vice President of World Championship Wrestling, says it's going to be one-on-one come heck or high water.
It's going to be one-on-one, Jim. There's going to be a winner. There's going to be no disqualification. The dudes with attitudes around the ring, they're there to be sure that the horsemen don't interfere. And as we said before, if Sting doesn't do it, he says he's not going to have any excuses. Look at that.
Ole Anderson, I got much room to sit down there. El Gigante takes up about two and a half chairs.
Yeah, that's right. But I tell you, Anderson's not going to go anywhere.
I tell you, Bob, I'd like to filter through the handcuffing, the dudes with attitudes, and get to this. This is what we came to see. This is the young man that people say will dominate the 90s against the man that has dominated the 80s, the Nature Boy. Collar and elbow tie-up, and Sting looking very strong in overpowering the Nature Boy.
Well, he has tremendous body power and stamina. Another thing that he's done, he's expertly perfected a Scorpion Deathlock, and if he can put that on Blair, it can all be over. Jim, the big question mark, of course, though, is Sting's knee. You know, he's worked hard and he's worked long, he's suffered plenty, but he's not wrestled. He's been working out. But that's not like actual combat in the ring. And will that layoff affect his stamina? And of course, he's got to avoid the figure four. Can you imagine the figure four if Flair gets it locked on the knee?
Oh, it's going to be deadly and probably the end of the match.
What's a clean break?
What about the Scorpion Deathlock? Flair has to be aware of that. Flair. Ooh. Ooh, wow, what a chop. You can hear him. Our camera's taking you right in there. You gotta think people around the country are flinching. And Sting walks right across. He's walking tall. Flair to the corner. The Stinger has got him up, and his legs are solid underneath. The military press and the Stinger dominating Flair.
He didn't hesitate at all. He went right to it. Evidently, he's not thinking about that knee, and he's certainly not favoring it.
High hip lock taken by Sting. Great drop kick right on a button on Flair. And the Nature Boy rolls outside in this battle for the World's Heavyweight Championship. The Stinger, starting his fourth year in wrestling, didn't debut to the top 10 until 88. Late in the decade that Flair has dominated. And that big chop.
Sting is not even blinking from those blows.
Flair, hip lock, boom, right on the ramp. Sting clotheslines him back inside the ring. And the world's heavyweight champion already in trouble as the Stinger seems dominant.
He certainly dominated the opening minutes of the match. It's been all Sting. He has really turned the offensive loose, or the offense loose. Flair's been on the defense ever since the match started.
I'm sure everyone probably assumes that this match will come down to Flair's figure four or Sting's Scorpion. I think both men have got those moves so well scouted, I don't think it'll come to that. Flair, thumb to the eye of Sting, whose face is red, white, and blue. Snapmare by the Nature Boy. Six times he has been the heavyweight champion of the world.
And as you said, Jim, the wrestler of the decade of the 80s, and he's considered by many of the experts as the greatest NWA champion of all time. But you know, no matter how great you are, the time eventually comes, Jim, when you fall. Could this be the time for the Nature Boy?
Well, the thing about it is, Sting has never beat Flair in a championship match. That's the difference. Flair, great suplex. He thinks he has the advantage, and Sting is up quickly. Sting up so quickly, nails him with clotheslines. A pair of clotheslines. And now the Stinger going upstairs. He's going to test the knee early. He's upstairs. He's up on top. High cross body. One, two, and a half. Flair barely got out of it.
Almost had him pinned with that cross body off of that rope.
Ric Flair, he was educated in a private school, the son of a doctor. From Minneapolis, Minnesota originally, now lives in Charlotte, North Carolina.
I got to tell you, I'm surprised at the way Sting is able to maneuver. Jim, I thought at least that knee would slow him down a little bit, that he would be a little careful with it. Heck, he's thrown caution to the wind.
I think the people in the media and the fans are more concerned about his knee than he is.
Yeah.
He says he's healthy. I've seen him work out on many occasions. I've seen him use the Stairmaster, the Life Cycle. I've seen him run, seen him lift weights. Bob, he looked 100%. It's hard to believe, but he looked 100%. But Flair, now let's see. This is the test.
Wait a minute. Here it comes.
Flair says he's the dirtiest player in the game. Going downstairs, working on the knee. That's the knee. Yes, of course. The knee that Sting had operated on.
Well, we pointed out many times that Flair will do anything to retain that championship.
Flair sends Sting for the ride. The Irish whip. But his clothesline out of the corner. Sting up high for the elbow. And the champion moves out of the way quickly. It's now Flair, spinning toe hold one. He's going to set for the figure four.
He tried to get that figure four locked in on that knee. Boy, it's amazing the way Sting is taking the blows and bounced right back.
His resiliency is, we thought, you know, one of his greatest attributes has always been his quickness. But I'll tell you something. We thought perhaps when the injury occurred that it would lessen his quickness. I don't think so. He's as quick as I've ever seen
Absolutely.
Him tonight.
Absolutely. I tell you, it's amazing. Jim, when you realize how severe that injury was, and I'm not sure that a lot of fans are aware of the seriousness of that injury and the serious operation that the man had to go through.
Big chop now, and that chop took its toll on Sting by the Nature Boy, who really laid it in, that big right hand. Flair picks the challenger up, tosses him outside. Now that's a test of the knee. Landed right on the knee on that rampway.
But again, Sting just shakes it off.
10 minutes gone by, 10 minutes
Flair
gone
with
by.
Another big chop there. Sting prone on the rampway. Referee Nick Patrick assigned this contest. This is the first time we've seen him tonight, assigned only this match. The senior official now in the NWA and World Championship Wrestling.
This is when Ric Flair is at his most dangerous, when he gets the opponent hurt.
He nails him with that knee, Bob. He goes for the chop and then he goes for the knee. Listen to, ooh. Wow.
Unreal.
Wow, what a chop. He's paying the price, says the champion of the world. Flair downstairs with the kicks to the knee. Sting limping now, noticeably. But who wouldn't be?
Even if you had a knee that had never had an operation and never been operated on. With a blow like that, you'd have to limp and operate.
Sting now fighting back. The Stinger with right hands and left. It kicks to the midsection. Flair now in trouble. The Stinger, that great explosiveness that we remembered. High hip block, taking Flair over. But he went for the drop kick, but nobody there. Flair, the veteran, stepped out of the way. And now will he go for the figure four? No, he's going to work on the leg, though. Drapes, oh, man, right across that bottom rope. He came down with all 242 pounds, the world's champion, taking it to the challenger.
Sting right now has got to be in trouble, Jim, and he's got to be wondering, what can I do at this point? Are my wheels going to hold up on me? Am I going to be on one leg for the rest of the match?
Flair has been on his sixth title reign since May 7th of 89 when he beat Ricky Steamboat at WrestleWar in Nashville. Sting quickly moved out of the way.
Well, Flair's doing exactly what we thought he might do.
Snapmare by the Nature Boy. Measure Sting, goes back to the ropes. Momentum, but nobody home.
Watch out.
Now Sting trying to go for the figure four. What a change in strategy. This crowd now is standing. They're anticipating Flair submitting here as the Stinger is using the Nature Boys on hold, and Flair quickly goes to the ropes.
He really turned the tables on the championship. I don't think Flair had any idea that Sting might try to do that.
Flair now pulling Sting outside.
That leg again, that left leg and that knee.
Taking it outside. Big chop, my God, what a chop. Sting's chest is a beaten red. There he goes to the railing. Back first, and he steps right back. He steps right back. Man to man, we're gonna go here. The look on the champion's face tells a story. Flair says, wait a minute. And Sting now, on top, it's Fist City. Straight right hands, and Flair, the great one, catches it coming in with a foot to the midsection. And now Flair upstairs, but the Stinger's got it. The Stinger has got it. Up he goes, slamming right off the top rope. But Flair fights back. They're trying to hip lock. Sting down under. Both arms cupped. Taking the shoulders to the mat. There's one. There's two and a half.
What a great match. Two great competitors going at it. And Sting, the way he bounces back, it's incredible.
Sting thought the referee's count was slow. I did not. In any event, Flair took advantage of the moment and swept the leg right out from under him. Going right for that injured knee. And isn't Ole Anderson quiet at far from ringside? There you see.
And there's the reason again. He's still handcuffed to the big Elegante. Nothing he can do but sit there and quietly watch.
Flair now measuring the knee, right on the knee. As flush on the knee as one could, like a bullseye was.
Jim, I think another important thing is that the dudes with attitudes around the ring, we haven't seen any of the horsemen around. That's another important factor in this match.
Flair now, straight right hand, or a kick rather, came with the right hand earlier, very effectively. Downstairs, not to the chest, downstairs was effective. Sting rolling away now, using the ropes to pull himself back up. Well, Flair measures him, goes for some momentum, and comes right back at the leg. Sting now.
He's got Sting reeling.
Yes, he does, Bob. He certainly does. And Flair pulls him to the center of the ring. Spinning leg lock, which is a primary move before the figure four. Sting kicked away.
Flair's got one thing in mind now, and that's that leg. Jimmy goes at it at every opportunity.
Ooh. Man, Sting's chest. He looks like he's been in a war, and he has. Nobody delivers those chops like Nature Boy Ric Flair.
It is certainly a war in that ring. Only the fittest are gonna survive. And who's the survivor gonna be?
Sting, I can assure you, will not submit, will not quit. Oh, Flair slapped him. Slapped him in the face and slams him in the chest.
Look at Sting.
Sting's just trying to reach down. He's trying to block out any pain. And Flair hits him so hard. He wants some more. He says, hit me again, and hit me again. And the champion is doing it. And look at his chest. The blood vessels have been broken. His chest is discolored. And Flair has given him all he's got. Will the knee hold up? Let's see. It held up, Bob. Amazingly enough, it did not buckle.
As he held him up to the air, even after all the punishment he'd taken on that leg, he was able to press him 242 pounds.
And ooh, good God, two and a half. I'm talking inches away.
Almost a new champion. As you said, just a matter of inches, and it would have been Sting, the World Heavyweight Champion.
Sting now the right hands. The challenger sends a champion upside down, down the aisle, and Sting clotheslines him from the apron. Oh, my God, what an offensive move. Big-time offense by Sting. And the challenger for the heavyweight championship of the world, now back in control.
He's got to be smelling that championship right now.
Standing vertical suplex. Sting on top. One, two. Flair kicks out.
Again at the count of two. And again the champion refusing to be pinned.
Flair back in the corner. Irish whip. Sting now. Look at the Stinger Splash. And he got him with it. He got him with a Stinger Splash. Oh my God, they're standing now in anticipation. Will we see the Scorpion Deathlock? Ole Anderson wanted to come down.
He's got him in the Scorpion.
He's got him in the Scorpion. How much longer can Flair? Here come the Horsemen.
And there are the dudes with attitude.
There's a fight on the rampway. But Flair trying to crawl to the ropes. Ric Flair doing all he can not to submit. The dudes with attitudes said they were going to keep it one-on-one, and they are.
The Horsemen gave it a try, but they couldn't make it.
But how much longer can Flair hold on? He's in the ropes, but the damage may be done. The damage from the Scorpion may be done. The heavyweight champion of the world has trouble standing. Sting with a big right hand. The dudes with attitudes holding off the Horsemen as Flair takes two big right hands.
And Sting has it all going.
Shoulder block. He's got his feet on the ropes, and Scotty Steiner just tipped him off. Flair would have liked to have had a cheaper. He'd like to have any kind of victory at this point. But he's got his scuba roll. Two and a half.
He's been that close several times now.
Side headlock by Flair. Head scissor by Sting. Sting gonna bridge up. Look at the strength of the challenger. He's got both arms tucked. Can he get him over? Flair on his shoulders. One, two, one. And we're inches. We are talking inches from a new champion of the world. Look at Flair chopping with all he's got. And the challenger is standing tall. Flair, the Irish whip. Sting went for the knee. He went for the knee. And Flair moved out. Flair going for the figure four. Sting's got him. Inside cradle. The DPO. Yes! A new heavyweight champion of the world has been crowned. Sting has upset Ric Flair to win the heavyweight championship of the world. The Stinger has done it. The Stinger has done it.
Sting is the winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner.
There's nothing we can say right now. Take a look at this crowd and take a look in the ring. Here's another look at it, ladies and gentlemen. Sting went for the big knee, but Flair moved out of the way. Very adeptly. And then it was Flair who was going to go for his coup de grace, the figure four. But here is the move that brought Sting the world's heavyweight championship.
Jim, when he was going for the figure four, Sting was managed to get him into the small package and roll him up and pin him quickly for the count of three. And there it is. And there he is with that world championship belt. What a champion he's going to make.
Many said it couldn't be done. Flair, without a doubt, is the greatest world's heavyweight champion of all time. But the Stinger, using an inside cradle as a reversal for the figure four leg lock, with his chest battered, with his leg, I'm sure, hurting, countered the champion for the 1-2-3. The crowd here, standing, they have seen history made here at the Great American Bash.
A tremendous bout and a bout of courage for the young man who went in with a knee, not sure what it would do, whether it would hold up or not, how he would be able to stand up against a champion. Jim, all the many thousands of questions that we asked for all these many months, they all were answered there. And look at that.
The new heavyweight champion of the world. His friends are with him. Gordon Soley, I think, is standing by back there. Junkyard Dog there.
We're going to try to get Sting over. Hopefully, Gordon's going to be able to talk to him, Jim, to get some of
Stinger.
His tremendous feelings and emotion
Stinger,
he must
boy,
have.
Get it.
Let's go to Gordon now. Gordon, take it away.
Congratulations, Sting.
My mouth is really dry, so try and understand what I'm going to say. Ric Flair is the greatest world champion of all time. Me, on the other hand, I'm a champion tonight and tonight only. I've got some big shoes to fill in Ric Flair's shoes. Although we may have our differences, all I have to say is I'm going to do the best that I can do. And that's it.
This has to be the happiest moment of your life, wasn't it?
Ric Flair wasn't champion 6 times with the help of the Horseman every time. He's truly a great champion. I know you don't want to hear it, maybe some of you, but it's true. It's a big accomplishment for the Stinger in his short career. Thank you very, very much, everybody.
Okay, thank you, Stinger, the new NWA heavyweight champion. Now back to Jim Ross and Bob Caudle.
Well, Bob, it's been everything we thought it would be. These great fans here in Baltimore, as the Stinger comes back down the aisle here. And these are his fans. He wanted for every fan, especially the little Stingers. These youngsters here at ringside with the paint on their faces.
And there's no